get fit, have fun, and burn calories.
You say this product is unique. Have you had a look at what else is out there?
Looking at the quick demo, it looks very similar to me.
Facing Lord Sugar's final round again, Ricky was forced into submission.
Well, Ricky, I have to say, the people that actually contributed the most are the ones that you have chosen to bring in. And it may be the ones that did the least get away with it.
Yes.
Well, yes.
Ricky made a mistake, and Alan told him so. He'd brought back Dwayne and Laura into the boardroom to the final three, and they had done the most.
Ricky survived.
Dwayne, you're fired.
Just.
You've got Nick and Karen to thank for you staying here today, Ricky.
Thank you very much.
Because if it was solely on today's task, I've got to tell you, you were very close to leaving also.
That, for him, was the launch pad to actually realise that I need to listen, I need to engage, I need to understand, and then I need to act.
After the fitness task, I did think I had to show Lord Sugar, Nick and Karen other skills that I had. It was important to show a little bit more of the Richard and a little bit less of the Ricky.
Thank you for the feedback.
Ricky grew up in Hampshire, the second of three sons.
I owe everything that I've got, everything I've done in life, to my mum.
After his parents divorced, the boys faced hardship.
My mum would have gone without food on certain occasions. She would have probably gone without new clothing on certain occasions to make sure that I had food, I had my school kit, I had everything that I needed.
Everything Ricky does, I think he has his mum in mind, as well as himself. He's always wanted to prove himself and be successful, and that is to look after his mum.
I'm just proud of my son. I couldn't wish for a nicer, happier son than I've got. He's lovely to me, he's good to me, he speaks to me all the time. He's just generally a good, good man.
I want to do her proud now, and I really want to give back to her by winning this process and setting her up for life.
Ricky was the first in his family to go to university.
He did very well in all his exams, and he was taking a really hard degree, which I was really, really proud of him for. Very, very proud.
After graduating, he joined a scientific recruitment company.
What makes me successful within the scientific recruitment industry, first and foremost, a credibility in what I do. I've got a degree in biochemistry. I love my science. I have a big geeky side, and I love talking about the science.
I think his team idolise him because of how well he's done. He is one of the company's youngest team leaders, and I think they aspire to be able to perform as well as he's done.
Ricky has been project manager twice, and he's lost both times.
It's absolutely devastating. I truly believe I'm the best person in this process, and it's gutting that I've lost on both times that I've led the group.
Leading a task to raise awareness of English sparkling wine, his pitch was flawless.
So our themes are quality, quality, and quality. We want that message to be crystal clear to people.
Oh, that's horrible! This isn't the English sparkling wine that we ordered!
But another disastrous video took the fizz out of his campaign.
This is the second time you've been a project manager?
Yes, Lord Sugar.
And this is the second time you've lost?
Yes, Lord Sugar.
You didn't bring your people into a win the last time, did you?
Unfortunately not, no.
Then we saw the bravado fall away, we saw the showman fall away, and we saw this real desire and passion to be in this process.
With the lessons that I've learnt from yourself, Nick and Karen, I feel like I'm a much more stronger person now, and the business plan I've got is so exciting. I've got so many ideas going into that. It is going to make money, and I'd love to be on that journey with you.
Welcome back.
How are you doing?
You're well.
Behind that thick skull, there's a big brain that beats at a very fast rate indeed. He's very structured, very articulate.
I think we've definitely started to see a more rounded version of Ricky, far less showman and far more businessman.
Thank you very much.
Nick Hulzer. Articulate.
You know, we've got something that you wouldn't usually taste together. That's what we wanted to do.
So
So we'll give you an order for 50 cases.
Thank you very much.
Perceptive.
For the first part of the day, the most important thing is to get an understanding of, of what is this wine, who buys it, why do they buy it.
And level-headed.
Before we miss out a certain step, we need to talk to the PM about it.
Right from the start, nerves of steel from Nick.
Is there anyone that wants to be the project manager? Anyone screaming out?
Put myself forward if nobody wants to do it.
He volunteers for the very first one. Yeah? At least he had the bottle to go for it when everybody else was shying away.
Congratulations.
You know, project managing seven people I've met for 5 minutes. A lot of pressure, a lot of responsibility, and, you know, he stepped up to the plate, so I had a lot of respect for him for doing that.
Being project manager, you're in the firing line, and I was aware that if I had lost that task or if I made too many mistakes, you know, I was in prime position to get fired.
Nick's team decided to print designs on bags and teddies to sell to tourists.
I think you should go for a smaller bears rather than larger bears.
Yeah.
Smaller bears.
I'm
making a decision, big bears.
Nick put himself forward to be the project manager in the first task, always the most difficult. People are fighting for the limelight, fighting to get their point across.
Would they buy a bear for £15? In terms of starting point, we're agreed on £12, yeah?
No, I've made a decision. £15 for there.
Holding together some really strong characters is a skill, and I think he showed that he has that skill.
Try and hit £325 each of sales today.
Nick spotted that high margins were the key to victory.
We'll make the most profit if we sell the teddies at £15. That's where the real massive margin is going to be.
The thing about Nick that impresses me is that he always gets the task. But he does that in a very calm and measured way. And that's a very, very good quality to have.
Nick's ability to understand the real issue in a task and grasp it was evident in the Flip It task.
It was Nick's second stint as project manager. Buy goods, spot top sellers, and reinvest in more.
It's not too heavy, it's not too orange, it goes on evenly, it's no streaks.
Smell what sells and get some more. Very simple.
All the tan's gone now.
All the tan's gone now.
So every bit of money we've got, reinvest it into tan.
We only want tan, so as much money as we can, straight into tan.
Who won the task? Nick did.
I gave you £150 and you demonstrated that in the course of a day, that you can change that into £955. And so very, very well done to the winning team.
Nick was born in Switzerland, showing little sign of the budding businessman he would become.
He was a very dreamy child, was not really interested in, say, in academic work very much or schoolwork, but he was very much interested in play.
Mum was possibly a little bit worried that I maybe wasn't that intelligent or that I may need some kind of help somehow. Didn't have a TV until I was quite a bit older. We didn't really listen to much music. It was very much based around building sort of camps out in the woods. My childhood was very much based outdoors.
But Nick's dreamy childhood was brought to an abrupt end when his father had a serious accident.
When I was 18, I was saving up money to go travelling. My dad had an accident, unfortunately, when he was paragliding.
The last thing I remember was the paraglider snapping open. I must have swung violently to and fro and landed on my left shoulder but I had blacked out by the time I hit the ground.
I was the only sort of family member really, sort of old enough or sort of responsible enough, I guess, to sort of sort everything out. So I had to spend sort of a few months helping him, you know, get back to England and helping him sort of recover from the accident.
Yes, that was quite a difficult time.
It was difficult being 18 years old and having quite a lot of responsibility.
I had to use my initiative, I had to use my common sense, I had to sort of plan things, organise things. And I think those are skills that I use in business every day.
In the end, Nick got his round-the-world trip and it helped him focus on business.
Travelling did have quite a big impact on me. You know, I was quite quiet and dreamy before I went. I think what it was about traveling that made me kind of interested in business was actually seeing how many different ways of doing business, whether that's selling deep-fried bugs on the street corner or whether it's selling trinkets or whatever. And I did come back more clear with what I actually wanted to do. You know, I wanted to do business, and I wanted to make lots of money, and I wanted to kind of conquer the world.
At university in Birmingham, spotting a gap in the market, he set up his first venture.
The first company that I set up, which was kind of set up while I was at university, it was called Kogo Mogo.
It was actually based on the campus itself. He knew that there would be lots of students there who were his perfect target market. They want a cheap cup of coffee, and he can provide that for them.
People love to buy the coffee. We had quite a big sort of fan base of it.
It's been so successful. I think the regional businesses around the area selling coffee have really struggled.
When I came to finishing university, or came close to finishing university, I did have some very attractive job offers on the plate. So I decided to take the sort of plunge into setting my own business up. It is difficult, really, really difficult to make money in business, but we succeeded.
After selling the coffee operation, Nick started a phone-based business card company.
We created a platform where users could link information about themselves to a QR code. You can click one button, it saves the entire contact details onto your phone. You link all your social media to it, and you can track how many people are scanning my business card, where are they scanning it from.
I'm really, really proud of what Nick's achieved. It's been amazing to see his success in his businesses, but it's not something we'd ever put past him.
Nick is a nice young man, and nice is a strength, but sometimes it can be a weakness.
When you see something going wrong, you've got to have the force of personality to rush into the middle of the fray and stamp your foot and say, no, you've got to change, this is wrong.
120?
I've got no clue in this. I don't buy this shit.
In week four, Nick's team created designs to revamp and sell on bric-a-brac.
They're all mini tables.
Do people buy this kind of stuff, as many tables?
£60, I probably paid for something like this. That's too small, perhaps.
I sort of think it looks like a box on a ladder.
He knew that that wasn't going to be the best way forward, but he didn't step up and he didn't say it.
I actually really like that.
Some of the things did look a bit odd. I think sometimes I'm a little bit too quiet. I say things and don't push them through enough.
And in week five, realising his team's fitness video was going wrong, Nick still kept quiet.
I think, you know, when we talk about the kind of the vision of what the film will look like, my big concern now is to make sure that we do create a martial art dance routine, not just a dance routine. I think we are in the danger of just creating another dance routine.
Back, one, two, three, four. Knee crunch.
I disagree, but it doesn't mean, as you say, one person leads it. I'm happy to go with it.
He was absolutely right. Did he roar in there, stamp his foot, do a double somersault and demand that things were changed? No, he didn't. And it cost them. They lost on that.
I don't think he's that argumentative. I actually think he's very easygoing. I think on occasions he should potentially maybe stand up for his ideas better.
The headline here is that everyone says, yes, a good idea, but not executed properly. So it looks pretty samey that things are on the market.
Nick's laid-back approach has a positive side. He's a natural peacemaker.
It's the same thing happening again. We have an opinion and you just don't like it.
No, it's not that.
Well, I'm actually getting a bit pissed off about it, if I'm quite honest with you.
You know, let's be friends on this, OK?
Yeah.
Shake hands, guys.
I'm all for... No, but let's not force it, like, I think...
The thing about Nick, he's very much a team player. He brings people together. He can't be bothered with the politics. It's all about the task, it's all about the business, and it's all about winning.
Team Sterling!
His mix of talent and character has gone down well.
I'm a green part, guys!
And in week nine, he was one of five candidates on offer.
You three, choose one of these people you'd like to come and join you.
Nick, please.
Nick.
Nick, you're very popular.
Welcome.
I really like working with Nick. He's a very intelligent man. He's very good at putting his point across. I think he's a really strong contender.
Being chosen by the other team to come over and join them was actually, a massive compliment to me. It made me, it did feel very, very good.
Nick's the most successful candidate in the final five, and actually he's never been in the bottom three.
Thank you.
But the downside of that is you don't get to be in the boardroom with Lord Sugar. He doesn't get to know about you. He doesn't hear your passion, sense your enthusiasm to be in the process. So he really, really now has to shine through.